I'm a MMA fan, you know, I watch MMA. I like the art of fighting and I admire it from afar because I don't think I can ever be a fighter. I don't even know how to punch. Like when my coach used to say, okay, we'll practice punching session. I used to punch like this, you know. I really don't know how to fight and I've never been a fighter. But I like watching fighting. And I think I have nothing but admiration for fighters. So that's why I watch boxing sometimes. That's why I watch MMA. And I've seen all the UFC fights, almost all of them. So it seems that Dana White is going to leave the UFC or... the first part was he had sold off half his shares. He had a 10% share in the UFC. After... the Fretita brothers, they are actually very well linked, to put it mildly, very, very well linked. People with the overworld, underworld, all the worlds, very powerful family. They are actually from a, supposedly from a mafia clan. And they were on the board of legislators and they have a lot of power. They have a lot of power. I mean, they are one of the most powerful families. It's like, you know, the Italian mob families. So these guys, you know, they're good. Very enterprising. Amazing business people with casinos and their connections with the who's who. So they purchased the Zuffa. They bought the UFC. And I think it was under what? Zuffa? Yeah? Not too sure. Okay. It was under their... This thing, they had bought the ownership and they bought it for 200 million or so, and they pumped in, forgive me for the numbers, but they pumped in a hell lot of money. And obviously after the success of Ultimate Fighter, the first one, it started to grow and sky was the limit. Okay, so it was a shocker when news leaked that they were planning to sell it off. First, you know, as usual, Dana White said, it's a rumor, and finally sold it off. And they sold it off for $4 billion, which was like a wow. Whew. And the Fretita, the F brothers, that's more easier. So they made their money. Now, Dana White is still at the helm of UFC. In fact, he is the face of UFC. I'll tell you, great fighters have come and gone. But there's only one Dana White. I'll tell you, hate him or love him, you can't get enough of him. I have nothing but admiration for the guy. I think he's an incredible, incredible businessman, incredible manager. I mean, he is a legend. Now, it seems that he is going to... He has already sold off 50% of his shares. So from 10% share, then he bought it down to 5%. Easily he would have sold it for at least 300 million. And now he has maybe another 5% left. This also he can sell it for, let's say 200 or 300 million. So easily he is half a billionaire. Doesn't have to work for a single day in his life. Now he... You know, he was part when they sold the UFC to this talent agency. Can't get the name. Everessence or something, some Chinese, whatever. Okay. Sorry, I don't have Google right now. So after they sold it, he was still 10% share, then became 5%. But he was a face. He was getting a salary. He was getting maybe profit share, whatever the deal was. Now it seems he's selling off the rest of the 5%, and there are rumors that he's going to leave the UFC. Now, I'm not too sure whether he will leave. Okay, I don't know why would he leave. In fact, he has he had that operation where they cut open his ear. It's a very graphic operation on YouTube. They actually show cutting open his ear, drilling a hole in his skull, and you can actually see that. It's on YouTube. They do it live because he had problems balancing, I think it's vertigo or something, very bad vertigo where he literally couldn't, you know, walk or focus. So I don't know if it is health issues, because Dana White is a very secretive guy. In fact, he's so secretive, he'll not tell you anything about him and Ronda Rousey, which is a fact. You can just check Brandon Schwab, Ronda Rousey's ex, when he and Dana White had a spat. That time he said, you know, Dana White doesn't leave anyone. He insults you left, right and center. So he was insulting Brandon Schwab, who was Joe Rogan's close friend, saying, stop getting off, riding on the back of Joe Rogan for popularity. That time he was just starting the Kid podcast. So it was not too popular. So then Brandon Schwab hit him, gave him back by saying, do you want me to spill the beans of Ronda Rousey and you? Something like that. And for the first time ever, Dana White backed off, because obviously Ronda Rousey wouldn't want her image to be tarnished. But it's, you know, like they say, there's no smoke without fire. So everyone knew that Dana White and Ronda Rousey had something. But obviously they'll never open it up. And, even if they did have, so what? Okay, so now, if Dana White sells off the UFC, sells off his shares completely, then he's only a employee kind of a guy. Okay? And then the question is, will he stay or will he leave? See, if he stays, he'll still enjoy big money. He'll still enjoy the power, the fame, the incredible, brand value that he gets. My only feeling is the reason he'd want to leave is because maybe the company is putting pressure on him to, you know, behave himself, you know, quote unquote. Because if you see, before the company purchased UFC, he used to literally, hurl profanities at reporters, at media. He didn't give a fuck, and I love that about him. He would literally tell his, shut the fuck up, you know. He would use enough and more F's and B's. It was so much fun to listen to him. But after this new company took over, he controlled. He kept it cool. He didn't insult reporters. In fact, he was even ready to work with Ariel Helwani, who was Helwani or whatever. Even though he hated him. So after he joined ESPN, they continued talking. Now the thing is, I feel, this is just my opinion, the only reason he would want to leave, the only reason, is if it becomes too suffocating for him to work. I mean, given his clout, given his brand value, he doesn't have to take shit from anyone. He will not take shit. If I was in his place, I would say, fuck you. I wouldn't give a damn to anyone. So I think what's happening is, because this company is going, you know, not only global, but it's trying to expand and become mainstream, the politics that are there becomes even worse. If you actually notice, when Dana White, when UFC was purchased, all of Dana White's friends, Matt Hughes, then Chuck Liddell, all these guys whom Dana White employed, and they were getting a salary as vice president and all that, they all lost their jobs, all of them, one swoop. The reason being is they were paid big salaries and they occupied positions of power only because Dana White wanted them, and because Dana White and them were friends, they're very close friends. So after this was taken over by this company, he didn't have that much say in the matter. So they all lost their jobs. But now Dana White has been, you know, he's been performing incredibly well. But I don't know, maybe it's work exhaustion, or maybe it is, it's time for him to move. Because, you know, after this happened, how many people have left? Mike Goldberg left, because Dana White got pissed off with him. Then that black guy used to always scream and shout to prepare the fighters before the weigh-ins. I don't know what's that guy's name. He used to have, yo, come on, you can do it. And he got removed. Then all of Dana White's friends got removed. So one by one, each one got removed. Even, what's her name, that UFC girl, Celeste, before she was enjoying such an incredible platform and position of power, after UFC got taken over, she was treated like an ordinary girl. And, you know, today she's not given that much importance. So one by one, you know, it's going into the mainstream. And I think Dana White is, you know, he has reached a point where maybe enough is enough. See, honestly speaking, it'll be sad to see him go. Seriously sad to see him go, because he is the face of the company. See, if you think of Apple, Steve Jobs, you think of bodybuilding, you think Joe Vader, you think Dell, you think Michael Dell. Boxing, Don King. Then who else? Tesla, Elon Musk. So you have all these legends, no? Who are so interlinked with the brand. If they leave, the brand loses a part of itself. Even Microsoft had Bill Gates. And, you know, once they left, it was never the same. Now, the risk is, if they leave, this sport will become ordinary. I'm not saying the sport will die out, but it'll not be as powerful as it once was. The good news can be Bellator, then bare knuckle fighting, all these other promotions will spring up. So there'll be competition. And UFC will no longer be the monopoly, because when you say MMA, you think UFC. So it'll be sad to see Dana White go. But I'm pretty sure he'll do something. He'll have Dana White's Contender Series or Dana White's Ultimate Fighting Championship, maybe, if he has the rights to that. But he, there are also rumors that he's going to start his own boxing federation, you know, kind of boxing he's going to manage. But overall, whatever Dana White does, he has a massive fan following. He has so many people who admire him, including me. And I'll tell you, it'll be a sad, sad day. It's like I felt the same kind of sadness when I found out that Joe Rogan would not be doing all the sessions. When, what's his name? Even Bruce Buffer will not be covering all the UFC events, because obviously he can't. Then, what that guy's name? That Mike Goldberg, he left, the announcer. You know, even when you have legends of the fighting game, when they leave, you feel sad. So the day Dana White leaves, I wouldn't be surprised if UFC stock prices just plummet. So, yeah, anyway, if you're an MMA fan, just, you can comment down below. I don't think there's going to be another person like Dana White. And after he leaves, there'll definitely be a decline after some time. Just like what happened with boxing, just like what happened with the, you know, bodybuilding. Yeah. Sad. You know, Dell and Apple and all that. There'll never be another main core legend. Anyway, this is my views. Let me know what you think. Alright. Love to hear from you. And if you're an MMA fan, let me know. It's nice to, you know, keep in touch with people of same, similar interest. Alright. You guys take care. Ah, by the way, who do you think will win? Francis Ngannou or John Jones? Love to hear your thoughts. I'm signing off. You guys take care.